Today we're going to be going over my most favorite purse. Soft spoken. First part we'll be going over kind of detailed soft spoken of everything that is on this purse. And then it'll go into the more intentional stuff towards the end. The crinkling paper will be taken out right at the beginning, so if you like that part. I'll put timestamps, of course, below. There will also be a silent version. So, let's get started. Okay. This is a bag I got about 15 years ago from an unknown designer. For how old the bag is, it is in really good condition. We're going to go over the whole thing from top to bottom, inside and out. Check seams, check all of the stud work, and make sure that it's nice and sturdy before we put it out for resale. Maybe put notes for repairs before I put it on sales floor. Okay, so. And we'll talk about how to process this type of accessory on the sales floor as well for stock team. So, first let's go over. It is stuffed. We're going to take the stuffing out and examine the outside, each panel material first, so this front panel, the back panel, and the two side panels. then we'll go into the accessories, which are these handles and this attachment as well, that we'll look at. Just get an overall look at everything. Feel if anything is loose. You can see the general pattern here is small, large, small, large, small, large, small, large, small, large, small. Shape it while it waited for inspection. We'll see the extent of that damage when we take the packing out. So, is it even? Yes, I know of a specific thing I'll show you. Side panel, large, small, large, small, large. And then this one, you can see there are large studs used as for the feet of this bag, which is clever because it doesn't take away from the design or the color of the plain bottom, and it really protects well. Like I said, I've had this for 15 years. This is a puncture wound, or puncture wound. Yeah, it's a wound, but puncture damage here, and that's really a handy spot so far. So this. This was the first one to be lost, so I replaced it, and this is just a pin that I found at a thrift store. I'll show you the inside, but these are hollow accessory studs, but they're really well stuck, which I'll show you. Design at a flea market, so it's a really interesting cheap item I found. Let's open it up and check the zipper. Really smooth zipper. Yeah. No snagging. I haven't seen it. Because it does tend to stiffen up when it's cold, and I don't want any cracks, because I know it is a somewhat cheaply made product. I just don't want to have any surprises, because I love this design, even if it's cheap. Let's check my handle. A little bit of damage on these. A little bit of cutting, a little bit of heat, I don't think. Fix it up. No snags. Hollow metal. Won't get into detail about how they'll fix that, but it shouldn't cost much as far as resale of the purse. It'll still be worth the same amount. Okay, let's take a look inside real quick. We just want to make note of how many pockets we have in here, because we don't want the salespeople to be opening the purse when it's displayed, because it is the only purse we have. So we want all the sales associates to know how many pockets there are inside of each purse or accessory, and really make sure that they remember the details inside, so we will take the purse apart if we have to, but we like to keep things in the source, like, perfectly displayed, so that you will want to keep your what you have there. See, a merchandiser has time to do other things. Honestly. But, alright, so what I found here, we've got the main compartment. Large. I have no measurements yet, but they'll have the tailor take note of them when he fixes the straps or whatever other damage we find. This is a single pocket, singular lined interior lining pocket with cotton, probably not real cotton, lines. Put things like lip gloss or things like that in there because it is sewn in the center, but it is one pocket, so you want things that can come in and out of there easily. Let's flip the purse around. We have the main compartment. We have a zip compartment. We have a secondary accessory compartment with a lining compartment zipper pocket. So you've got a series of zippers in one section here, which is nice in some ways and confusing in others if you just gotta stay organized with this one. There's a lack of wallet holders, chains for security and things. I don't see any of these. So those kinds of features weren't taken into account in the design of this particular purse. But that, for how cheap it really was, I am surprised at actually what I'm seeing. It's the first time I've ever looked inside and at the actual quality of it. And I thought that it would have fallen apart much faster. So that's nice. Just a little bit of damage on the edges is fine. Okay, so now we're gonna put the pockets, zip this up. And we're gonna do a quick stud count to get an idea of how many we're gonna need to order if we want to redesign this particular type of studded material. Got estimates. Okay, so let's count the smalls first. Here we go. So 54 of the smaller ones. Let's count the larger. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 45. So 45 in the front panel for large. And then I'd imagine it'd be doubled for the other side. The same design. So these times we have, count all together, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. It should be one less on this side. I think it's really lucky that the one that was loose happened to be the one in the center, because it really, I think, adds to it a little bit. You don't notice it at first. Okay. Let's really check this stuff out now. This is where you want to look for damage or dirt and just make note of it, because that will be made note of for the tailor, who will also clean material. We don't have to worry about that. I'm just running my fingernails underneath the rim to be sure that there are no loose studs. A little bit of some gapping on a couple of them, but it doesn't surprise me, and it also could just be the angle, but some dents. I'm seeing dents on the studs, which is no big deal. I think that the dents add a little bit to them. They show that the purse is held up through some life. Okay, these all feel really good. Since these are the loose ones on the side, I'm gonna take that over. Like makeup. These are fine. We'll keep this here. Some dents on these as well. Yeah, these feel fine. They're not gonna come off. Okay. These felt so solid. I'm not gonna worry about the other side of the that for now, because it seems pretty well put together. Okay. And I'm just kind of looking. This is where we can check seams. Those all look good. A little bit of damage on the corners, which is normal. Kind of how you can tell it's so look fine. Here. Even with the overlap, it seems fine. It's really evenly sewn. On all four corners in the bottom. It's fine. Technically, this will be a vintage bag. It is. The design itself is over 20 years old if I got it 15 years ago. Assuming. So that's how we will decide on the pricing. When it comes into the store team, these kinds of accessories need to be labeled. If they're worth $500 or more, you need to have the connecting here so they can only open it so much to look inside and feel the fabric. They can also have that undone. That is undone by a code or a scanner, but that is just for making sure they can't put anything else inside of it or, open it any more than that. There's no really need for that unless you're a serious buyer. So that's the only one that we would put on this bag. Sometimes you'll have a tag that you can place if there's a designer. This one doesn't have any interior tags. But if it did, you could use the tag and slip it through there, like something like this, but the designer version of it, and keep it there. And then with the combination of not being able to open it, they can't remove that since the inside. Okay, let's just take one last overall look at everything. Just really pay attention, see if we find anything that we need to make note of before we never see it again. do a quick overview of that as well. Surprised at how long this has lasted me. It's a good bag. This strap can be adjusted. It's about the shortest as it goes. It can be adjusted to a longer length, of course. But it has these kinds of C or G clamps, I guess. I don't know. But they swivel, so it's easy to deal with them. I usually would want this over this zipper and that one. It leaves more appealing, kind of. It doesn't lop to one side, it holds both ends, especially when it's full. With the strap on it. Even if I didn't use the strap, it looks, it almost adds to it. It's a little dramatic. What it needs to be anyway. It's a very loud bag, I guess, but if you wear it with a plain black t-shirt dress or something like that, it's just maybe earrings, then it's not so dramatic. It's like your flare. ready.